Hey guys, welcome back to another video, and in this video I'm going to show you guys three things that you can change on your settings, your gameplay, as well as your mindset to become a better controller player in Fortnite. Hopefully this works for keyboard players as well. I try to make this video as universal as possible, but definitely this is targeted towards controller players because I'm going to be giving tips, and I'm a controller player, so I'm going to give tips to people who are on controller. But if you're a mouse keyboard player, then definitely still watch until the end of the video. Maybe you'll learn something new, and yeah, I really hope you guys stay to the end of the video because I have a surprise at the end of the video. Anyway, I am filming this video at 12:45 a.m. in the morning, or based not yeah 12:45 a.m. in the morning, and I'm very tired, so please forgive my voice. I'm gonna try to not make this video too long. I don't want to make this video 8 minutes long, so yeah, let's just get right into it. So starting off with a couple of settings changes. So the first settings changes we're gonna make is the HUD scale. Make sure it's at the very least 80%, if not 100%, but anywhere between 80% to 100% is advisable in my opinion, purely because if you have a low enough HUD scale like I do with 65%, now I only do 65%, keep in mind, because I'm not a controller of Fortnite Pro, but if you want to be the best possible player then you can be, then definitely go at 80% and above. Now why do you need to do this? Well, it's because you definitely need to see your health, your mats, your minimap, as well as the bullets that you have on your guns. You don't want to spend too much time trying to look at your inventory, trying to look at your resources, trying to look at your map, because you want to focus on your gameplay. So all of these are just, you're just going to look at them at the corner of your eye, and anywhere between 80% to 100% should do the trick. Now, don't go past 100% purely because that's just going to be way too big and you're not going to be able to see anything. So yeah, anywhere between 80%, I personally recommend 80% because it's not too big that it's going to take too much of your screen, and it's not too small where you're not going to be able to see your HUD anymore. The second tip, or the second settings change, is for controller players who do gyro aiming, please turn the setting off. It just makes it so hard for you to aim. I know it helps with a little bit of control on your aim, but trust me, it does not. And if you are doing gyro aim, then you are smart with it. But if you're just starting off and you're trying to improve, or if you want to improve and you're not used to gyro aiming, then I don't recommend turning it on. But if you are used to gyro aiming, then you know, feel free to do it. But I just don't recommend it to people who are starting off, as well as people who want to improve and they're not used to gyro aiming as much as people who do. Another settings change that I've told a lot of my players before, or not really a lot of my players, but a lot of my audiences, is to make sure that ADS turning boost ramp time is at 0.20 seconds and 10% on ADS look horizontal speed and ADS look vertical speed. You can check out ADS takeoff video for a more in-depth video on that. I'll link that in the description. And finally is to enable visual sound effects. Most pros use this now because sometimes you can hear, or sometimes you can't hear footsteps, or it specifies what you heard, and that just helps with figuring out, you know, if opponent's coming, if somebody's shooting, and if you don't have, like, if you don't want to have maximum volume, then yeah, this is gonna help a lot. And even if you have maximum volume, this is also gonna help purely because you're gonna learn, you know, if someone's shooting at you, someone's nearby, and something like that. So yeah, definitely enable visual sound effects. It'll help you become a better Fortnite player. Okay, so let's go to a gameplay advice that I think will help both controller players as well as keyboard players. So whenever you're trying to go for a piece, let's say you're smacking on a wall, I don't recommend going for a big edit play like this. Really, it doesn't help because it opens up a shot and your opponent is probably going to be able to shoot you at that point. There's definitely a better way on how you approach this. So let's say your opponent's boxed up, you're trying to smack his wall and you get his wall. The normal option for this for most people is to make an edit play, either shoot, try to place a cone, if not a cone, stare and then go for a mongrel play. Now this sometimes works, but I don't recommend it for people because this is a 50-50 and there's a high chance that you're going to get hit by your opponent. So to avoid this, you want to make sure you want to utilize your right hand peeks by doing something like this. Make sure you're using windows when you're trying to piece somebody because it just makes it easier for you to control your opponent, and it makes it harder for your opponent to hit you. And in that scenario, you're probably going to win the fight because your opponent hasn't hit you and you have full control over your opponent because you've pieced them without having to take too much damage, and with them having literally no opening to you, and you having full control over your opponent once again. So let's talk mindset. Now the mindset that I'm going to teach you is just literally to be decisive with the moves you make and make sure to commit to the moves that you make. Now why do you need to commit? Why do you need to be decisive? Well, if you are not decisive, then you're going to be filled, or your brain is going to be riddled with just a lot of unnecessary thoughts, and you just don't want that in the middle of a fight. You want to make sure you're fully focused on what's happening, and if you decide at the moment and you do not commit to it, you make regrets, you make bad decisions, and yeah, it really doesn't help if you're not committing to the decision that you previously make. Whatever it is you made, whether it's wrong or right, whether it's right or wrong, you'll always commit to that decision and then live with that decision, and trust me, you're going to become a better player after, you know, putting that into your mind and trying to practice that in real games. You want to make sure you're committing yourself into it, because you don't want to stop. You want to keep going with the momentum that you have, and by that time you have that momentum, you should be able to win the fights you take 98% of the time. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you did. Subscribe if you're not subscribed already, and turn on post notifications so you are notified of videos just like this one. And I hope to make more videos of these types of content. I really like talking to a mic again. Yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video, and goodbye.